When I hear the president talk about the rhetoric that security officers don't care about their students, that teachers care about their students, that we should arm teachers because they care about their students, I think of a man named Aaron Feis. If you don't know about Aaron Feis, he coached the offensive line at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. He sent two athletes to Division I football, which is incredibly hard at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. He was a great guy, and he was also a security officer at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. And when he heard that there were shots being fired, he ran towards the shots being fired, and he put his body in the way of bullets to save students. If that doesn't tell you that security officers care about their students, I don't know what tells you that they care about their students. Peter Wang, 15 years old. He's a 15-year-old JROTC student who, when gunfire was raining down on him and his classmates, he made the conscious decision to hold the door open for countless students. He lost his life that day and saved between 60 and 150 students. His dream. His dream was to attend West Point and be appointed at West Point. They sent two officials down to his memorial where they gave him a certificate saying, Class of 2025, congratulations. I have no doubts that he didn't need this to happen to get that. He would have gotten it all by himself. Peter Wang, 15 years old. Luke Hoyer, 15 years old. Carmen Centrum, 16, now 17 years old. Aaron Feis, 47 years old. Alex Schachter, 14 years old. Nicholas Doran, 17 years old. Helena Ramsey, 17 years old. Chris Hickson, 49 years old. Meadow Pollock, 18 years old. Scott Beagle, 35 years old. Alana Petty, 14 years old. Jamie Gutenberg, 14 years old. Joaquin Oliver, 17 years old. Alyssa Aladev, 14 years old. Gina Montalto, 14 years old. Kara Logren, 14 years old. And Martin, 14 years old. Those are the 17 heroes that lost their lives protecting the other students at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. They all made a conscious effort to save someone else, and they lost their life because of that. I'm sick and tired of my heroes having to be buried. I'm sick and tired of my friends having to be buried. And I look out into the crowd and I see so many creative signs, and I see someone is holding up a picture of Joaquin in the back. I don't know if you realize that's who you're holding up. That's not Joaquin. Oh, they're all walking. I can't see. I just see the one with him in the beanie. That's how I remember him the most. And to quote his favorite artist, Frank Ocean, he says, I feel their smiles on me. I feel all of their smiles on all of us in here because they know that we are not going to stop fighting until change happens. It is around the corner, and we're going to March 24th, all of us together, and then come together and demand change. I'd like to introduce my brother, Ryan. This is you, Ryan.